Okay. We begin today, chapter 9. Of course, it's a continuation of previous class. Previous class, we learned that 5 degrees of separation there is in the human being. It all begins with intelligence, and in intelligence itself, it begins with chokhmah. Chokhmah is the source of intelligence. It's that flash of ingenuity, intuition, you might even call it, so to speak, on an intellectual level, that has an entire idea, an entire thought in a seed-like manner. It needs to grow from there, of course, into Bina. So we have intelligence, and intelligence, what does intelligence do? It feeds our emotions. That's what it's meant to do, not the other way around, right? That's called justification, right? When you justify your emotional disposition by now, from your feelings, bringing it up to your mind, right? But the way it should be is from the mind, understanding something, understanding a truth, feeds it to the heart, that the emotions are now focused based on the intelligence of the mind. So that's 1 degree of separation. All of that is in a sense subconscious, meaning that there is no language at that point. It's beyond a form of language. Where does language begin? Is in thought. And in our thoughts, we think in language. Intelligence is beyond that. That's why some people who can't speak, right, they still have intelligence. They still have intelligence. The intelligence is not based on, well, of course, the clearer capacity that a person has in speaking, the more it reflects intelligence, but it only is expressing the intelligence. Doesn't mean that there isn't the intelligence there. In any case, so from our emotional makeup, right, that which we have strong emotions towards, that's what we're going to think about. That's another degree of separation, right, in thought. And then from thought, where language begins, where letters, right, begin, then there is, those letters are now put into speech. And that's a further come down, right? A further come down. As we have it in speech, it's much more powerful. The way it is, our letters of thought are much more powerful. There's a come down, a degree of separation, right, as it comes down into speech. Now, when we say come down, not in the impact. Obviously, the impact on another is coming through speech, not coming through one's thoughts, primarily said, right? So we're not talking about impact here. We're not talking about value. We're talking about the actual power of thought is a much more refined quality of the human soul than is speech. To be able just to think, right? I mean, we take it for granted because it, you know, we can't turn off thought. Speech we could. Just to show you about how the quality is, you know, a come down, so to speak, of the power of the soul. So that's another degree of separation. Then finally we have action, right? Well, before a baby can speak, before a baby, well, they're thinking already, but perhaps not in a primal manner, not in real letters of thought. It's actually an interesting idea there. But there's action. So a child can, you know, plays with the hands and, like, you know, all of a sudden gets a focus and tries to grab something with the hand, right? Then finally they learn how to walk before they can talk. And so on. So that's 5 degrees of separation. That's in the human condition. Intelligence, the power of intelligence of the brain, is the greatest of all. Is the greatest of all, right? In other words, it's a great separation between our intellectual capacity and our emotional capacity, our speech. I mean, sorry, thought, speech, action. However, to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to the Holy One, blessed be, to God, right, the level of wisdom, which is in all of created beings, is the beginning of thought and its genesis, right, which is the beginning of all, you know, in God's wisdom, right, as it's found in the wisdom of creation, is to God the final stage of action. Meaning, in relation to God, wisdom is considered as if it were the quality of the level of action. As it says, Kulam b'chokhma sisa, that you have made them all with wisdom. Now, you know, what does it mean? Colloquially, we would say you make something with wisdom, but you make something with your hands. Action comes, making is with a hand, or right? Is that, that's how you make something with your hand. You don't make it with wisdom. Through wisdom, yes, with wisdom, but it's not done with wisdom. It's done with our hands, right? But here it says that you made them all with wisdom. Means to say that wisdom relative to God, right, as is the quality of the life force in the physical and material action, is in relation to the quality of the life force of wisdom. In other words, there's so many degrees of separation between wisdom and the human soul to an action that it's incomparable, right? Totally incomparable. The wisdom versus to the physical action of something, right? In other words, if the life force that's in the, you know, the physicality of moving a hand is nothing in comparison to the life force of speech. Speech is incomparably greater life force of the soul, right? And in turn, that's nothing in comparison to the life force that's in the letters of thought, which in turn is nothing in comparison to the life force that's in the level of the emotion and all the attributes, which thought is derived. Thought, which is in a language, in the emotional makeup, it's in this, it's, we're talking about prior to language, it's much more powerful. And in turn, that's nothing in comparison to the life force that's in the level of the degree of wisdom, understanding, and knowledge, Chabad, which is the source of the emotive attributes. So, exactly in that manner, the level of wisdom, which is the beginning and the source of all life force in all of the worlds, right? Which, what does that mean? We're talking about Chachma in the highest world of Atzilus, right? Which the world of Atzilus, the world of emanation, is the beginning of and the source of all of creation, right? That level of wisdom, right? God's wisdom we're talking about now, of Atzilus, in relation to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, to God, the essence of God, it's nothing. Right? That power of God that is the source of creation, the wisdom, relative to God himself. Right? In other words, God's wisdom, talking about God's wisdom, but let's understand, what does it mean? It means wisdom of Atzilus. Right? The emanation of God as it is in Atzilus, relative to God himself, right? The essence of God is incomparable. It's not comparable. It's not 5 degrees of separation as it is in the human condition. The human condition, 5 degrees from our intelligence to our capability of action. But God, the Holy One, blessed be He, is high and exalted above the level of wisdom by an infinite myriads of degrees. Infinitely removed from the power of divine intellect, divine wisdom. again, we have the challenge of not looking at God the way we see ourselves, right? We have 5 degrees of separation from intelligence, emotions, thought, speech, and a physical act or physical reality. So, relative to God, the highest level of divine intelligence, relative to the essence of God, is infinitely removed from it. Right? God is infinitely removed from that. Now we're going to go further into this idea to appreciate and to understand this. But hopefully what we're getting an idea is that we can't put our experience and understanding of things and superimpose that upon God and the way he is and the way he does things. So for God, so to speak, divine wisdom is like action. Meaning, it's so incomparable beyond him. And we're talking about divine wisdom. Now, what's the point of this? We're going to see where we're going with this. The point of all of this is to understand as best as we can God's unity from within diversity, within a diverse world. It's a step-by-step, day-by-day process on how we can appreciate this reality, that when we see a world that we can understand with our minds as best as possible, that the reality and the makeup of that of the world is the divine light of God. So what we're doing right now is understanding the divine attributes and divine intelligence relative to God. Now, we're still in the middle of this idea, and we will continue. It's an evolving idea, so it's sort of like in the middle. And until we get the full thought, it's a little challenging, shall we say. Let's go into some questions, perhaps. Anybody has a question? Anybody has something to share? And again, where we want to go with this is to be able to appreciate the koyach ha'poyel v'nifal, the power of Creator within creation. This is not so much about our relationship with God, the personal relationship with God. As I think before I pray to God in the Amida, the prayer that standing before God, and so I think of myself as a child before God. I think of myself. Or as a servant before the master, standing in the presence of God, that I'm there in the presence of God, speaking to him. So as a child, and also with a great sense of awe, standing before God, trying to, evoke that within me. Now, that's about my relationship to God. That's not what we're trying to accomplish over here. Here we're trying to accomplish is to appreciate God's realness in this world. And we're in the ninth chapter. We have 12 chapters. Hopefully by the end of the 12th chapter, we'll have a certain clarity that we will be able to see the world differently. you know, as I clean my glasses, you know, and that allows me to see physically more clearly. The Alter Rebbe's teaching is going to allow us to see more spiritually clearly with our mind's eye. And that's where we're going. So stay tuned. As I've always said, you guys are amazing. Day in, day out. Really focused on the teachings. Great. I'm looking to take these teachings to another level. And if anybody is in this, whether in social media or in any other manner that either can help and direct me or be involved for hire, please let me know. Because these teachings are crucial. All right. I don't see any questions. That's fine. We will continue tomorrow, God willing. Reminder, TRC, Tanya Rabbi Community. It's beautiful. And please reach out to me if you have any interest, and that we can help out to make sure that if you need some appreciation or understanding or whatever the case may be. I'm Rabbi Ronnie Fine, coming to you from Chabad Zuch and Kadesh in Montreal, Canada. Good to be back at home. Routine.
Welcome back, Rabbi.
Thank you. Thank you. And reminder that we have Rambam right after this. So have a great day. A good Chodesh Tov. A good month. An amazing month. This Shabbos will be Gimel Tammuz, the Rebbe's 28th Yortzeit. Going to make a Fabringen. It could be Sunday. Probably Sunday. All right. Sunday afternoon, something like that. Have a great day. Good Chodesh.